Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am artist Xu Beihong's daughter. I'm a pianist and author. Thank you. We're going to talk about three artists at this concert. Alexander Chepnin, Jiang Wenye, and Xu Beihong, represented in this concert, shared a similar objective: integrating East and West, pioneering a new direction in their creative work. Here you can see on the screen Alexander Chepnin. He was a Russian-born composer and pianist. With his lifelong interest in China, he created many pieces from Chinese melodies and legends, including the chamber opera, The Nymph and the Farmer, you just heard. In the 1930s, Chepnin promoted and taught composers in Japan and China. In the 1930s, he also promoted a famous Chinese composer, He Luding. Jiang Wenye was born in Taiwan and educated in Japan, where he started his career as a composer and met his mentor, Alexander Chepnin. Besides commenting on his compositions, Chepnin also encouraged Jiang Wenye to understand Chinese culture and Chinese music. In 1936, Chepnin took Jiang Wenye to Beijing and Shanghai on a field trip, allowing him to get in touch with Chinese life and cultural traditions, opening up a profound new world for Jiang Wenye. As a result, Jiang Wenye moved to Beijing, where he expressed his new feelings about China in his piano work. He was among the earliest to write Chinese music for Western orchestra, and also pioneered Chinese piano music. His orchestral work, Taiwan Dance, to be performed next, won a special prize at the 1936 Berlin Olympics art competition. My father, artist Xu Beihong, is widely known as the father of modern Chinese painting. In 1919, he became one of the earliest Chinese art students to study in Europe. With the knowledge he gained during his 8-year study there, he successfully integrated Western painting methods and technique with traditional Chinese painting in order to develop Chinese painting. He also modernized China's art education system, mentored generations of Chinese artists. Xu Beihong is best known for his dynamic ink brush paintings of galloping horses. His animal paintings often express deep meanings through the use of analogy in a subtle way, which achieves the richest expressions in traditional Chinese painting. For example, here you can see Vigorous with New Life. This painting was created in 1934 when China's northeast fell under Japanese occupation. In this painting, the artist expressed his expectations for China through the awakened, powerful lion leaping across the mountain valley. The background of Chinese paintings is usually sparsely filled. However, in this painting, the whole paper, including the water, was painted over to portray an atmosphere of a hot summer day, as indicated in the inscription. This background makes the white geese stand out. More details of Xu Beihong and his art can be found in my memoir, Galloping Horses, Artist Xu Beihong and His Family in Mao's China. It is available on Amazon, also at the book signing at the immediately following this concert in the front lobby. You can find more information from my website, beihongchinaarts.com. Next, I'm going to tell you about the piano concerto on this program. I'm going to perform and a story behind it. Piano Concerto, Xu Beihong's color and ink paintings, was created based on two Xu Beihong paintings. The first one, we are only going to perform the third movement, so I'm talking about the third movement, is based on two Xu Beihong paintings. Rooster Crowing in the Rain was painted in 1937 on the eve of the Sino-Japanese War. In this painting, a rooster standing on a tall rock, crowing against the rain and the wind. This painting symbolizes Xu Beihong's expectation that the Chinese people would rise against the Japanese invasion. The second painting, recalling past valor, was painted in 1937 to commemorate the 5-year anniversary of the January 28th incident when Chinese army fought Japanese invasion in Shanghai. Looking upon the past, the artist expressed his strong emotions about this heroic national struggle. The rooster, with his head held high, is a symbol of the bravery and perseverance of the Chinese people. You can see the yellow flowers taking much of the space in the painting supports the optimism expressed here. I made a CD containing this piano concerto's third movement and also contemporary Chinese piano music played by me. It's available at the book and CD signing in the front lobby immediately following the concert. This piano concerto's manuscript lived through China's social transformation during the second half of the 20th century before surfacing recently. Jiang Wenye became a friend of my parents in the late 1940s. When he taught composition at National Beijing Arts College, where my father was president. In 1950, he became professor of composition at New China's Central Conservatory of Music. Despite losing his privilege after being branded a rightist during the anti-rightist campaign, he persisted in creating this piano concerto, Xu Beihong's color and ink paintings, portraying Xu Beihong's hope for a bright future for China. In 1964, composer Jiang Wenye wrote this piece of music for me, Xu Beihong's teenage daughter, and the piano major at the Central Conservatory's Preparatory Music High School, hoping that someday, I would perform this work for him, even after his passing. To him, that might be the only possibility that this work, this major work during the latter part of his life, could be known to the world. However, The manuscript of the piano concerto was lost during the Cultural Revolution in 1966, and only the third movement was recovered recently. If Jiang Wenye were alive today, I would say to him, "Teacher Zhang, I'm finally living up to your expectations. You will be delighted to hear me perform the world premiere of this lost work in Alice Tully Hall at Lincoln Center in New York." Thank you. Next, we are going to perform a capriccio, Xu Beihong. Composer Huang Anlun composed a capriccio Xu Beihong commissioned by China Now Music Festival. He was inspired by two paintings. He selected two images out of half a dozen images that Xu Beihong's daughter provided him. The first painting was oil painting Sound of the Flute, created in 1926 during Xu Beihong's student years in France. In this painting, the lonely melody from the xiao played by the woman in the painting expresses her reminiscence of homeland China. Xu Beihong expressed his joys and sorrows and his hopes of a bright future for China through his horses and the inscriptions that he chose for his horse paintings. In 1941, he painted this galloping horse in Penang, Malaysia, during the war of resistance against Japan. As I said, his inscriptions express his feelings. In this painting, he's inscribed, "I'm very concerned about the Second Battle of Changsha." In this symphonic poem, the latter half of it, with thousands of horses galloping, the sound of their approaching hoofs created a powerful and splendid ending. And that is six galloping horses. I wrote a book also called Galloping Horses, artist Xu Beihong and his family in Mao's China. And you can see that in the book cover, that's Xu Beihong. And you can guess that little girl, that was me. And then the little boy was my older brother, who is also a painter. These galloping horses offers untold experiences of Xu Beihong during the mid-20th century China. It also describes the perseverance of his widow, Liao Jingwen, my mother. Her dedication to Xu Beihong's artistic works and cause made the Xu Beihong Memorial Museum possible after his passing. My mother was the museum director, Xu Beihong Memorial Museum director for 60 years. That is Liao Jingwen in mid-1940s. That is Liao Jingwen as director of the reopened Xu Beihong Memorial Museum in 1985. Xu Beihong's family members struggled to preserve Xu Beihong's legacy and accomplished his unfulfilled missions. The author also describes her life and education in mid-20th century China and her experience as a professional musician in Madame Mao's model picking opera. The book is available on Amazon and also available at the book signing in the front lobby immediately following the concert. Again, you can find more information from my website, beihongchinaarts.com. A Chinese version, Chinese translation, is available in ebook form. You can find it in Apple Books, Kobo, and other ebook platforms. If you go to my website, go to book purchase and click iBook, it will take you to Apple Book, and here's the book cover. So welcome to the book signing and CD signing in the front lobby.
Thank you.
take this opportunity to donate a copy of my memoir, Galloping Horses, Artist Xu Beihong and His Family in China, and my CD containing the piano concerto, third movement of Xu Beihong's color and ink paintings to Bard College Conservatory, US-China Music Institute.